All right, Pokemon Yellow time. Let's do it. All right, everything seems to be all good from that end, I guess. All right, sorry to keep pausing it, but geez. I had to make sure I had to check everything to be sure. Just had to make sure everything's all good and ready and stuff. By the way, Visual Boy Advance is not kind. Visual Boy Advance is not kind in the very slightest at all to this sort of situation. Because it makes Pikachu's voice all weird and stupid. Alright, so all one of you watching, you're probably gonna watch on YouTube. You're probably just gonna, like, watch on YouTube anyway, so who really cares, but... we're doing this here, and... I welcome you to the Pokemon Yellow livestream thing that I'm doing, because, well... Okay, here's the thing, actually. I actually originally wanted to stream this game, like, stream Pokemon Yellow, like... on the time... or at least near the time of Pokemon Red, Blue, and Yellow's re-release on the Virtual Console. But that's the thing. I got sick. The Mac flu got to me. Because MacFest flus are a thing that I need to deal with. So, yeah. Unfortunately, that sickness happened for a while, but... fortunately, I seem to be doing alright, in a sense. I seem to be doing okay to just keep on streaming good. I have my water just in case things happen. So with only, like, one person watching, because, well, one person just watches me at all times, meaning me. The game is in stereo. I bet you all didn't know that, didn't you? Like, okay. It always seems to be a thing that bothers me. Like, people don't really seem to get that this game has stereo. Like, this game has stereo, and no one ever uses it. And it wasn't a thing when red and blue was a thing, but it's a thing in yellow, so... yeah, it's a thing in yellow. Who would've thunk? Who would've thunk it indeed? So I might as well do this here. Let's get on into it. Let's do some classic Pokemon memory stuff. On my PS3 controller, because my PS3 is, or no, I'm not playing this on PS3. I'm playing this on the emulator. What the heck am I even doing there, man? So yeah, this is Pokemon Yellow right here. Basically put, think of it like the definitive version of Pokemon Gen 1 that you should play. And you know what? That's the thing. I actually did an LP of this game, like, a really, really long time ago, on the old Windows Movie Maker, am I right? On Windows XP, am I right? But, yeah, I did an LP of this, like, long ago on my YouTubes, and, you know, it kinda sort of didn't do that. So, you know what I'm probably gonna do? I'm probably gonna make this, like, a livestream playthrough series, just... make it like a live stream playthrough series in which, you know, I completely trump this LP more than anything else. So, yeah. And by the way, since you can name your rival whenever you want and no, like, profanity filters, like, keep you from doing this. Yeah. Ah, damn it! I thought for sure that would fit, actually, but nope. It didn't. It didn't fit in the very slightest. Nah, I could name him Dick, because I already named him my Leaf Green Let's Play that. Well, you can literally name your rival whatever you... well, you can literally name your rival whatever you want. And you might as well name him, like, the biggest asshole ever. So, you know what? We're gonna... you know what? We're gonna name him Asshole, because he's an asshole. That's right, I remember now. His name is Asshole. Shows what he knows, how does his grandpa not know who he is? Like, honest to God, how does he not know? Like, let's be real. Let's honestly be real and just say that, hey, my grandson's an asshole. But anyway, here's something that probably would never fly today. You have an SNES. That's always been a thing in Pokemon. It's like, you always have, like, the latest Pokemon, or the latest, Nintendo console in your home. And, you know, like, the latest Pokemon games continue that sort of tradition, where it's like, oh, you have a Wii U, and somehow, in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, you also have a Wii U too, even though the GameCube should exist in that time. Maybe that's why, like, people don't like Arras so much. Or at least some people that I talked to MacFest, aka the biggest Pokemon nerds I know. And you know what? I don't get that. I don't get that at all. But anyway, what Red's watching here is just basically like Stand By Me, I don't know. Like, Red is just basically watching Stand By Me, which is rated R. Four boys are walking on railroad tracks, and apparently, like, someone else is talking. Because physics. Because your character can actually speak. It's probably, like, the only time ever that your main character can actually speak. It's weird. But anyway, yes, this is Gen 1, everybody. This is Gen 1, or at least one, or at least me. I'm lonely. But that's okay, because you're watching on YouTube anyway, and somehow that gets a lot more views than, like, most of my LPs combined. Shoujo, you know, getting freaking only, like, single-digit views on, like, part 78 of my Xenoblade Chronicles Let's Play, yet freaking part 5 gets, like, over 500 views. What the hell? Okay. Yo, Ash, Gramps isn't around. I ran here because he said he had a Pokemon for me. Well, it's right there. You know, you could always get it. You could always get that very Pokemon that's right there, I guess. But anyway, what does this say? Save option is on the menu screen. Cool. Yep, and it's right there. Right there, this is all your assets. Right here, your items, your trainer name, your etc., your more etc. And all the other etc's too. It's encyclopedia-like, but the pages are blank. Okay. There's an email message here. Yeah, people still use emails in this time. The elite trainers of Pokemon League are ready to take on all comers. Bring your best Pokemon and show and see how you rate as a trainer. Pokemon League HQ, Indigo Plateau. P.S. Professor, please visit us. Okay. Is there anything in this trash right here? I highly doubt it, but we can't. Can't really check it. Apparently these guys are like twins because they say the exact same thing over and over again. I study Pokemon as Professor Oak's aid. True. Truth. But anyway, I'd just rather explore Pallet Town here because, well, there's actually plenty of things to do. And yeah, Asshole's House. Yes, Asshole's House. Heh. I love naming my rival after curse words. Because that's what Nintendo did back then. They didn't have profanity filters. They had stuff. A town map. And yes, this was Kanto back in the day. Where it was all colorful and whatnot. And we had all this to explore on a Game Boy. Like, seriously, Pokemon was like my life back then. Pokemon was just seriously my life back then. Like, whenever I go back from school, or sometimes I take it to school, and just, you know, just play it. Like, honest to God, I would just play it. While Pokemon live in tall grass! Wait, how the hell did you even run into a random encounter in Pallet Town? Also, how the hell did you get a Pikachu? They're supposed to be in Viridian Forest, you ass. Also, how the hell did you get it on your very first try? Well, technically the Gen 1 catching system is broken as hell, so... yeah. It's broken as hell. You need your own Pokemon for your own protection. Ah, no, why did I make him sound like a countryman? And of course, Professor Oak is dragging me against my will because why? I mean, like, why not? Gramps, I'm fed up with waiting. Hmm? Asshole? Why are you here? Why do I keep slipping into my inner Joel? I swear to God. I swear to God, he's like a beast from Vine Sauce, but... Yeah, you know what? I found it kind of weird that I slipped into my inner Joel by the times, like, I went to MacFest and stuff. I kept slipping into my inner Joel because I thought it was funny. But it's not. It's not funny at all. Be patient, asshole. I'll give you one later. Well, I'll tell you one thing. It's certainly not going to be that Pikachu. I mean, it's not like this game is named after Pikachu anyway. So I'm getting this Pokemon. Hey, to check it in. Hey! Hey, asshole. Asshole snatched a Pokemon. I don't really get why they feel the need to, like, bring in a fanfare for that. Like, honest to God. Gramps, I want this one! I could just probably imagine him being like a big baby about it. But yeah, he was going to give one anyway. Blah, blah, blah. So, this is the Pokemon he caught earlier. You can have it. I caught it in the wild, so it's not tame yet. Well, duh. Anyway, Pikachu! Let's see. Since there's no one in the chat, I can do whatever I want. Ha ha ha! Or maybe I can, like, confuse some things and make my own chat. So, a name for Pikachu. Name for Pikachu. Well, Pikachu is a mouse. And Lucajin already took the best name. I'm probably gonna name it something stupid. Pokemon... Elect... No. Too soon. Oh, I know. I'm gonna name Pikachu George Tech. George Tech. Oh man, okay, I'm probably gonna regret it, but you know what? Yeah. I'm gonna name it George Tech. Because why not? Because I'm talented. And I can do whatever I want. Because there's no one in the chat to control me. I'm all alone. I can do whatever I want! Heh, my Pokemon looks a lot stronger. Yeah, so you know what? We're gonna battle you. Yes. I'll take you on. Yes. And once again, didn't even know that the battle theme could be in stereo, did you? You didn't know this? Because no one ever uses stereo. No one ever uses it. But yeah, these were what battles were like back in the day. They were all simplistic and all that stuff. Everything was just one screen. Sprites were, like, really weird. Actually, the sprites weren't really weird in this one because they were actually updated to make it closer to how Ken Sugimori wanted to be and stuff. Oh! Help. Help. Tail Whip does a lot of defense lowering. Jesus Christ. But yeah, please don't. Oh, yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. I need a critical hit, but I don't care. But there it is. There it is. Tail Whip learned, and I defeated Asshole. What? Unbelievable. I picked the wrong Pokemon. Well, it was the only Pokemon on there. It was honest to God the only Pokemon on there. Seriously, what the hell? So he's going to make his Pokemon fight tough enough, and apparently he has a speech option. Also, what the hell? Would you look at that? It's odd, but it appears your Pikachu dislikes Pokeballs. You should keep it with you. That should make it happy. You can talk to it and see how it feels about you. George, how do you feel about your name? And apparently the Pikachu voice is a little bit too quiet for my liking, but yeah. If only this was an actual 3DS, but I don't have any money. So basically, if you couldn't tell, this is basically based on the anime where it's all like, Pikachu pops out of your Pokeball and you can follow it around. Pikachu, unfortunately, does not have the ability to evolve in this version. Plus, you can't also, like, stick it into the PC, so... yeah. So, that's a thing. So, that's kind of like a little bit of a flaw with Pokemon Yellow, honestly. Even though it is kind of, like, the best version to play, it is sort of a problem where, like, Pikachu automatically takes, like, permanently takes up one slot of your party, only letting you, like, choose between, five Pokemon in your party and stuff. So, yeah. This guy works at a Pokemart, so he's going to visit us in Viridian City, so he's going to give us a sample, and it's a Persian! Also, get ready for, like, very limited party space, or very limited item spaces, because Gen 1 had limitations. See those ledges along the road? It's a little scary, but you can jump on them. You can get back to Pallet Town quicker that way. Of course, hey, this guy was a Pokemon all along. Of course, we run into a Pidgey here. Just want to take it out. And bada bing. Basically put, Pikachu just basically wrecks on this route. Pikachu just fucks shit up. Like, honest to God, like, wrecks stuff. Like, if it's a Pidgey, then fight it. It's pretty much yours for the taking. Also, if it's a Rattata, you're probably gonna have a lesser time with it, but, you know, just basically beat it down like that. And you're all good to go. Also, one thing that's exclusive to Yellow is that the game actually changes color depending on where you are. Isn't that just revolutionary? Then again, this was like Game Boy Color standard, so yeah. My Pokemon didn't get hurt, so I can just go ahead and go to the Pokemon and do the thing. Okay, actually, hold on just a little bit of a second right here, actually, because gotta check briefly what Skype is up to. and nothing important whatsoever. Okay, so all good to go, and we're continuing. Just had to go for a brief moment right there. And yeah. So now we're getting Oak's parcel here. And of course, we gotta give it back to him. You know what, actually? Playing this game on a controller is actually surprisingly natural. Like, there were those times in, like, Pokemon Stadium and, you know, Pikachu's dancing. Yeah, this is a well-known secret that if you jump on a ledge and not let Pikachu, like, jump with you, you can actually make it dance. So that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool to see. And Pikachu is still not impressed. You know what? This just really makes me wish that I had, like, a... that I had a freaking, 3DS capture card, because then I could, like, play this game on an actual 3DS, so Pikachu's voice will be, like, just as good as it was back then. But, unfortunately, that's unfortunately not the case. Oh, Ash, how is my old Pokemon? Well, it seems to like you a lot. You must be talented as a Pokemon trainer. Yeah, I must be. I obviously must be very good. In keeping with the lore of everything. Okay. I can feel my throat already, like, getting tired, so I might as well keep my throat hydrated. By the way, I must ask you to do something for me. Asshole Gramps! This was people back then. This was your rival back then. My Pokemon is growing stronger. Check it out! Ah, asshole, good timing. I needed to ask both of you to do something for me. On the disc right there is my invention, Pokédex. It doesn't have THE Pokédex on it, but however, we're just gonna name it Pokédex anyway, just because why not? Boxes, dialogue boxes were very limited back then, even on a Game Boy, so it's a high-tech encyclopedia! Ash and asshole, take these with you! Yay! To make a complete guide on all the Pokémon in the world. That was my dream! But I'm too old, I can't do it! So, I'm entrusting you two, 10-year-old boys, just 2 10-year-old boys to fulfill my dream to me. I'm pretty sure you can survive on, like, bread, water, like, in the wilderness. But, yeah. Do it. Ash, I hate to say it, but I don't need you. Like, you even needed me in the first place. You know what? Ever since Pokemon Origins, like, a lot of people have, like, shipped, like, Red and Blue. Honest to God. All because of what happened in, like, the second episode of Pokemon Origins, honestly. Like, you know, when Red... you know, when, like... Blue was all afraid of the ghost Pokemon, and he was all like, "Oh my god, Red, hold me in your arms!" But... yeah. But anyway, this will help us. A town map. Yay, like we even needed in the first place. What is exactly the point of it? I mean, I get the town map is important for, like, all sorts of things. Like, you know, stuff. But for first-time Pokemon players? But honestly, if I'm gonna be completely honest, you know what? As veterans, we don't really need it. We, honest to God, don't even need it. It's just the fact that we know everything and everything that we can do. By the way, I'm not running from any battles whatsoever. Nope. Just because my Pikachu is that OP. Pikachu is that OP. Honest to God. But something we can do right now is buy Pokeballs. And live and exclusive on Twitch, where you'll be able to get all sorts of this exclusive content. Actually, it'll be uploaded to YouTube anyway, but... this is actually gonna go into a thing that I might do in my future Pokemon LPs, actually. So, yeah. It's been an idea. It's actually been an idea in my mind, like, how I might handle future Pokemon LPs in terms of my team and all that stuff. So, here's what I'm gonna do. I am going to try to get every Pokemon that I possibly can. And... pretty much just like, I was sort of inspired by Pokemon Origins to do this because, you know, Red swats out his team because, you know, he's completing the Pokédex in that very special. And, you know, he just keeps on swapping out his team and all that stuff. So, I am going to do the exact same thing. By catching as many Pokemon as I possibly can. And, you know, just gonna have some variety on my team. But honestly, I'm just gonna name my Pokemon after, like, stupid names, because who wants to name, like, Pidgey Flappy Bird anyway, am I right? I'm gonna name it Fappy Bird, because that's funny. Right? I mean, that's comedy gold. I mean, honest to God, that is comedy gold, am I right? And my Pidgey was level 3, I wanted it to be level 4. Oh my God, okay. What should I do? You know what? Yeah, I'm just gonna, like, just keep on thunder-shocking this thing. Or not. I can just do that. I guess. By the way, Guts wasn't flying type in this game. It was, normal type, I think. Which is why Pikachu didn't have the, didn't resist it, I guess. A lot of the internal, like, Gen 1 mechanics was really weird, honestly. Like, you know, Guts being normal type, Slash always getting a critical hit, you being able to catch legendary Pokemon at full health in a Pokeball. Like, honest to God, yes, you were able to do that. And yeah, as clearly evidenced in my Pokemon Yellow Let's Play when I caught Mewtwo. Just, yeah. Are you just leaving all these Pidgeys for me to, like, kill? Like, seriously? They're just letting me kill all these Pidgeys. It's the Great Pidgey Massacre 2016. Alright, come on. I'm not using the speed up feature. I can literally use the R2 button and— oh. I didn't think I would find level 6 Pidgeys, but I'm kind of tempted. I'm actually kind of tempted to get a level 6 Pidgey here. So you know what? Yeah, I'm gonna do it. I don't care if I have, like, a second Fappy Bird on my team. I don't even care. There he goes. So I might as well do it just because, well, I have, like, the ability to do that, so why not? Well, except I'm not gonna name it Fappy Bird, I'm gonna name it Fappy Burb. Because talent. I obviously have the talent to, to do that, but whatever. Also, get used to this text box. It is the only time you are ever going to see it. Trust me, I know. Shall we heal your Pokemon? Yes. I kind of like how Pokemon Yellow actually adds Chansey to the Pokedexes, or the Pokemon Centers. Jeez. Making it like the Animu. Yes, indeed. Okay, I'm just gonna put this other Pidgey in the PC here. And yeah, you could also print boxes too. That's actually another thing about this game, is that it was compatible with the Game Boy printer. And no one ever used it. No one ever uses it whatsoever. The Game Boy printer. I feel bad for the Game Boy printer, honestly. Alright, so Rattata. Finally get another person watching. I see you. Did you stumble upon here just because, well, you had nothing better to do? I honestly think you have nothing better to do, but it's kind of rare to see, like, someone on Friday. Someone on legitimate actual Friday to actually do things with. Alright. So, I'm gonna actually use this Rattata here. Sometimes, I guess. Overbite. No. I'm gonna name it Timmy. Turner. Because it had the teeth. And stuff. Yeah. I'm incredibly talented. Plus, I actually use lower cases, so that's good. I guess. That's good. Right? So that's basically every Pokemon on Route 1 caught. So, I'm gonna do me the doo-doo sparrow. And that one, and that other person is gone. Yay. That's what I like to see. People going away. Because, you know, I'm great at streaming. I'm good. Okay, so where we're headed off to next is Route 22. Because there's actually a lot of Pokemon that we can get here. Including one that is actually really useful, only found in Yellow, honestly, so, yeah. There we go. Nidoran male. Let's go. And also Rattata's sprite. Rattata's forward sprite for the win. Okay. So, get it! It was caught! Its large ears are always kept upright. If it senses danger, it will attack with a poisonous sting. I kinda tempted to name this thing John Cena. So that's what I'll do. I mean, like, there's obviously, like, other John Cena, like, related Pokemon, but... Nah. Because I love naming Pokemon by after stupid things. Like, no joke, during like, my earliest live stream, Pokemon, Red, I believe it was. I, honest to God, nicknamed one of my Pokemon, Miley Cyrus. And it was like a Nidoran female. In fact, if one shows up right now. Oh, right on cue! There it is. There it is. One thing to actually note, actually, is that, I believe Nidoran male is more common in Pokemon Red. And female Nidoran is more common in, blue. So, that's a thing that's interesting. Bada boom. The Pokeball glows blue. A mob manner Pokemon that does not like to fight. However, it will fight because, you know, you captured Pokemon. Duh. What should I name it? What should I name this guy? I do not have a chat to decide. Nah, I probably can't decide, so I'm just gonna name it this. It's the return. The honest to God return. And it fits perfectly. So I'm just gonna heal up my Pokemon here. Okay, I'm gonna see how Twitter's doing here while I heal up everything. Literally, the only person online is me. I love being the only one here. Then that means I can do whatever the heck I want! So you know what? I'm actually gonna do the thing in which I use John Cena. Because, you know, I like raising like way more Pokemon than I originally intended. I know what you're thinking, Pokemon people. Why am I not using the speed-up option? Well, the answer is obvious. I don't like using it. I don't like using that thing. It makes you seem incredibly cheap. I know who you are. I know who you are! Jesus. Why do people, like, use up the speed... Why do people use the speed-up function on it? Like, is there LP, like, a Pokemon... game on an emulator and stuff? Like, why do they, honest to God, use that? Like, seriously, why? It kind of just shows that you don't care. Kind of shows that, I'm sorry, but it kind of shows that you kind of don't care about, you know, trainer battles and stuff and just explaining what the heck, like, you do or some... Okay. It just kind of shows that you don't even care about explaining, like, what the hell gyms are all about and stuff. You always speed up gyms. Why do you do that? Why do you do that? Controversial opinion. Jesus Christ. Makes you seem, like, incredibly cheap. And not good. Jeez. Okay, so rant aside, the pain of showing what the heck Pokemon you can catch is real. Because, well, yes, paralyze. Thank you. Now I can actually kill this thing like a lot easier. What if it actually turned out that like, that you could actually kill like a limited amount of Pokemon, therefore making this a genocide run of Pokemon? That would be most amazing. And yet the most heartbreaking indeed. But whatever. I suppose this is like the grinding session of the part of the stream, so I'm gonna use like the speed up function on this. Only through various methods, because only for grinding, because well, using them to train your bat for anything else other than grinding is just stupid. So you know what? We're gonna do this. We are going to grind up our Pokemon like nothing else. And why did I use Leer? Why did I use Leer? Because talent. I have the confidence to do this in my Pokemon. That's what I clearly do. And oh, there we go. There it is. Mankey. Yep. This is a Pokemon that you can only catch in Yellow, this early on in the game, in Yellow. And trust me, when we get to Brock, because, you know, your starter Pokemon is Pikachu, right? So, having a fighting type like Mankey for the first gym is absolutely amazing. Like, seriously, it really is. Because, you know, rock types are somehow weak to fighting types for some reason. So, yeah. Do it. Do it up. Let's see. You know what? I'm naming this after that freaking Jimmy Neutron monkey. That freaking Jimmy Neutron monkey you see at the end of every episode is like, "Hi, I'm Paul." Jeez. That's what you always do. That's what you always see at like at the end of every episode. It's like you see that monkey and then you see like the guy looking at the sunset being all like, "Hi, I'm Paul." So I'm freaking naming it after freaking Paul for crying out loud. Paul. That monkey stupid thing. But yeah. Anyway, Spearow. Ooh. That's actually a tough catch here. And apparently a very strong catch. Hello. Jesus Christ, I have like so many Pokemon at my disposal right now. So this is probably gonna make things like really confusing and really, really boring. Just like seeing all these Pokemon in action. So catch it. Hey. So there it is. I caught all the new Pokemon on this route. So Rattata is the only exception. Inept at flying high. However, it can fly around and do very fast to protect its territory. Yep. Yeah. Wesker. Like, aside from Execute, there's really no, like, other egg Pokemon that fits, so. Wesker. Egg. Yeah. Doing it. That's what I'm doing. Hey! Screw you, Nidoran female. Screw you! Okay. How does it feel to beat up on your own and on your own opposite guy? And, oh god. Oh god. Jesus Christ, okay. Okay. No, no, no. Okay, good. At least I beat it. And I grew to level 4 in the process. That's good. Okay. Just gonna speed along through here and just get all the Pokemon back to full health. And I am immediately replacing that Pidgey with a Spearow, because honestly, I feel like Spearow is the better of the two flying types, honestly. So, rip Fappy Burb. And, I'm probably not gonna make use of, Timmy Turner. So, Wesker Egg, get over here. And, let's see. So, it's Nidoran Male, Pikachu. Female Nidoran, Mankey, Spearow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Huh. Let's see. Well, those are basically just 2 Pidgeys and a Rattata, so I think I'll be good with just 5 Pokemon for now. Yes. So now begins the, training session, I guess. So I'm just gonna basically speed along through. Just gonna basically, speed along through. this particular thing, and I am going to, well, turn off my microphone, I guess. What should I do for these grinding sessions, actually? Well, I don't really have a chance to do whatever I want, so I can just do whatever. So, I'm just going to, well, get things prepared and all that stuff. So, you guys are probably gonna have some nice relaxing, some awesome music to play in the background while, you know, stuff is going on with me just grinding up Pokemon like nothing else. So, I'm going to save my game immediately, because, you know, saving takes faster time with speeding up. And, yeah. So, I'm just gonna turn off the sound here. And gonna go into a little bit of a thing in which I turn on music. Let's see. I'm gonna actually do Xenoblade Chronicles X music, because why not? That music is good. And gonna get the extended version all up in here. So, and also I'll check Skype again. Poof. Else. And now I'll let the Xenoblade X music spin, I guess. Alright, turn this. Now I go back to stream happy fun times. Because, you know, training with this music sounds really awesome, actually. Alright. So this is the training session, I guess. So you know what? I think I'm gonna basically make this a live stream playthrough series. To basically be like a solid remake of my Pokemon Yellow Let's Play, I guess. I suppose. Because, you know, that's a thing. Okay, go to level 5. Very nice. And, oh, Jesus. Okay. Meanwhile, Pikachu's gonna get all the power. Boy, if I had a chat right now, I would be answering some questions. I should probably not dwell on the fact that, you know, oh my god, I don't have a chat, this makes me sick, but you know what? Streaming alone can be like a beneficial thing because it'll allow you to do whatever you want without like any repercussions whatsoever. I suppose. I mean, that's how I would take it, but, you know, it feels kind of lonely. But whatever, wow, this Dude, your goal is like all over the place. Jeez. Now we get Thunder Wave. Yes, Thunder Wave is going to be proving to be very, very useful. Very, very useful indeed. For like all sorts of Pokemon captures and all that stuff. See another person in chat and like watching right now. This is just basically a grinding session that we're doing right now, or not really a grinding session, but the grinding part of the stream. Yeah. So get ready to see like a lot of speed ups and all that stuff, because I have a feeling like only some of these Pokemon are gonna be used in the whole grand scheme of things, I suppose. Okay, my basic goal here is just to basically get, like, most of the Pokemon up to level 7, I believe. Oh, also someone is doing chat stuff. Cool. What the heck? I thought that was my end. Yes! You thought it was your end, but it's my end. It's my end. See, my computer has this stupid thing. My computer has this stupid thing where it, like, go in and out of my internet. Like, honest to God, it will go in and out of the internet. Like, holy crap. I swear to God, it's like my laptop only, it's like this laptop is the only thing that does this, but holy shit, it's just, it's so infuriating sometimes, but whatever, I gotta live with it. God. Okay, I'm done. I'm done ranting about that. I'm probably just gonna put, like, the streams. Same here, man. I had to go get a new router with a fiber optic last year. Well, it's not really so much so my router's fault. It's more or less my laptop's fault. Like, honest to God, it kinda is. But whatever the case. I feel like I'm only gonna use, like, 3 of these Pokemon. Actually, no. No, I'm gonna use all of these Pokemon. I'm gonna use all of them. So the grinding session continues! Yep, the grinding session continues, and I'm going to put on, actually, New Los Angeles from Xenoblade X. Because that's what I do. Okay, so that's gonna be a thing. Alright. Okay. So, with that out of the way, tell me, Mr. Chat person thing, or at least the only one in the chat that is here. Because, you know, great if you're seeing this. Good if you're seeing this, because this is like the only time I can live stream. How are you? Good conversational topic. Wow, Paul grew to level 34 on sticks right here. Holy, on sticks. Wow, it grew to level 4 on sticks. Jeez, I'm good, man. I'm already at Giovanni as I rebought Blue when it was re-released. Whoa. Dude, I think that was like nearly a week ago. Holy shit. That was pretty good. You are pretty fast. Actually, you know what? that actually brings me to something. Like, as a kid, like, when I bought, like, one of my copies of Pokemon Red, like, one of the two copies of Pokemon Red I had, I, honest to God, actually, I don't think my battery pack in my, Pokemon Red copy was working, so I got through, like, most of the game in one sitting up until the point where I got to, like, Missing No and all that stuff. Because, well, the game didn't have the ability, or at least my cartridge didn't have the ability to save. So I would just leave it on, like, all day long and just basically play the game, like, a whole lot of times. And so, okay, BRB, okay, good. So I might as well continue my story. This is going to be on YouTube anyway. But yeah, it was, like, one of my battery packs on my Pokemon Red didn't have the ability to save, so, yeah. It was a fun time for me, I guess. Oh, jeez, what the heck am I gonna do with, like, putting this thing on, you know, the net? Or on the YouTubes? I think I'm just gonna, like, somehow edit, like, the two live streams together, I suppose. Okay, phone call, okay. That's good. And yeah, my gold and silver original cartridges need the batteries to be changed. Alright, yeah. Apparently Game Boy games have that sort of thing where it's like, oh no, the battery pack is dead. Might as well just let it be dead for the rest of my life. And oh my god. Oh, okay. I swear to god, if Miley Cyrus had that critical hit, that would have been amazing. That would have been just pure ecstasy to just see, like, oh my god, a level 2 Pokemon beat like a level 7 Pidgey. Holy shit. That honestly, like, never really happened to me before, but it did. By the way, I should also say who I am so you can actually follow me on Twitter. Yeah, okay, I'll follow you. You know, I'm always looking for, like, other people to connect with, so do it. Put up that Twitter, son! 1, 2, 3, 4. And also, Paul's at level 7, so I should probably stop grinding him up. So I'm going to grind up Miley Cyrus. But if you do want to follow me on Twitter, just scroll down and you can see that little Twitter panel right there, so you can follow me on Twitter if you so desire to. That's why I added in brand new panels and stuff. Wow, George Takei is at like level 9 at this point. Wow. All the glory of training up Pikachu. Because Pikachu is the most omnipotent thing ever. Can't hear you. I can't see you. I swear, if any of you have played Xenoblade X, huh? I already followed you. Huh? 1, 2, 3, it's weird because I am like terrible with names. I'm a fan of Channel Awesome. Yeah, I am a fan of Channel Awesome. Wait. If you are who I think you are, that would be absolutely amazing. If you are who I think you are, then that would be just the most amazing thing ever. Because here's what I'm thinking. In the chat right now is the same person who does that artwork for Nostalgia Critic. That's what I'm predicting. Tell me I'm wrong on this. Hello third person who has arrived here. This is basically the grinding part of the stream at this point. So, yeah, I'm going to stop grinding soon. Oh, you are. You are that same person. Oh my god. That's pretty good. Nice. nice of you to come by and just chat with me. That's amazing. I'm like ecstatic about this, honestly. Then again, like, nah, I probably shouldn't say that, but still, this is great. It's pretty cool. No problem, man. It's just avoiding work. Really glad you like my work. Yeah, I really like your artwork on stuff. Really, really glad. Really glad that you do that. All right, almost done grinding up Nidoran female. Oh my god. Okay. Just a few more levels and then I'll be okay. Then I'll be okay to go on to there. Okay, good. All right. So, gonna heal up one more time at the Pokemon Center. And there we go. All right. Stop the music. And keep on going on the music here. By the way, I saw a tweet about Paper Mario last night. Yeah, the franchise is pretty much... Oh my god, like... I was just probably mad. Like, here's my reaction to that last night. Like, as someone who's only played, like, Super Paper Mario... And knows of the other two's love, like Paper Mario 64 and Thousand Year Door. Like, I understand why people really like those games, and I've seen a few things about those games, and yeah, I really need to play them. But as someone who's, like, gone past World 1 in Sticker Star, and got really bored of the game, like, really quickly, because the game is honestly, like, not the best, it's kind of boring. Like, the writing was good in Sticker Star. Like, honest to God, it was good for, like, the characters, but... Yeah, whatever. But having Color Splash on the Wii U, like, oh my god, we're finally getting a console Paper Mario game again. It's like, nope! Sticker Star 2, baby! Oh my god. Everyone was so salty. Everyone was just so salty. It was so funny. But then again, who knows? Maybe the game will actually be good. Anyway. So now that grinding session is all over and done with. So, surprisingly, Nidoran female doesn't really get any attacks. When it levels up to, like, or at least level 7. But yeah, Pikachu now has Thunder Wave, so that's really awesome. And yes, I really need to play Thousand Year Door, because I've been hearing that's, like, the best Paper Mario. Like, again, I've only played Super Paper Mario, and yeah, I understand why people may have been turned off by that game, but if I'm gonna be completely honest, it kinda has sort of, like, some of the best villains in Mario history, I swear. But yeah, I've only played Super Paper Mario. I really need to get, like, Paper Mario 64 on the Virtual Console. I really do. And yeah. Alright, so surprisingly, no one else has learned any other moves other than, Nidoran Male and Pikachu, so... That being said... Going over to Route 22, because there's a rival battle that needs to be done. And Asshole is gonna be so surprised. Hey, Ash! Hey, Asshole! You know what? That's what I probably should have done. I should name my character Asshole. Are you going to the Pokemon League? Forget it, you probably don't have any badges! The guard won't let you through. By the way, did your Pokemon get any stronger? Oh, you have no idea. And yes, I agree. Count Black is like one of the best villains in Mario. I love him so much. And that backstory too. But anyway, surprisingly, your rival now has Spearow at level 9, so... Kind of a difficulty spike right there. If you literally just got off of, like, doing the rival battle in Professor Oak's lab. And if you're now just starting to train up your Pokemon to heck and back. And now I'm thinking Miley Cyrus could do this. I'm thinking Miley Cyrus can do this. Also, how the heck did you miss tackle? Jeez. Oh, Jesus Christ! help. Counterpart, go! Go, counterpart, go! Water. Okay, horn attack. Do it. Do it. Go. Alright, come on. Come on, Spearow. You got this. There we go. Alright, so that's it for Spearow, and now there's his Eevee. So this actually comes to a little bit of a thing that people don't often know about Eevee. Well, I get the feeling that some people know about this, but most people probably don't often know this about, you know, Gary's Eevee, or at least your rival's Eevee, is that his Eevee can actually evolve to one of the three different forms of, you know, evolved forms of Eevee, depending on your performance in these battles right here. So, take for example, if you win both of the battles right here, between Professor Oak's Lab and Route 22, Eevee will evolve into Jolteon. If I believe, if you lose both battles between your rival at both Professor Oak's Lab and Route 22, Eevee will evolve into Flareon. And if you win one and but lose the other, then it'll evolve into Vaporeon, I think. So, yeah, it's pretty obvious that I'm going to win both of these battles, therefore Eevee is going to become Jolteon at this point, but yeah, I win. I just win. Aw, you just lucked out. Do you believe the Gary's Raticate theory? Oh, that theory. That old theory. Well, here's the thing, like, here's the thing about Gary's Raticate. Like, it is true that, like, in Red and Blue, like, Gary's Raticate is never used again after, you know, after SSN, I believe. And in the battle, in the very next rival battle, like, his Raticate is, like, no longer present. And he's at Pokemon Tower, where all the dead Pokemon are. So, I'm guessing that's sort of what leads fans to believe that you actually killed his Raticate, but I don't know if I personally believe that, because, well, that's the thing. Like, your Pokemon in battle can only, like, literally faint. At least that's my theory of it. Your Pokemon can only faint, so I'm assuming that either your rival release Raticate into the wild or put it in a PC for, you know, other uses and stuff. So, yeah. I don't personally believe the whole Gary's Raticate theory, but it is a rather good theory, I'm not gonna lie, but I just don't believe it. And by the way, my mouse is in the way. So this old guy right here is gonna show us how to catch a Pokemon, even though we already caught like 5 Pokemon at this point. And he failed anyway. Wow. I've forgotten that he actually fails here. It's probably like the only time ever in like a Pokemon tutorial where like someone actually fails to catch a Pokemon. When I go shop in Pewter City, I have to take the winding trail in Viridian Forest. Okay. I like to believe it. I mean, you can't find a dead Marowak, then anything in the game becomes possible. Yeah, actually, you know what? That is a good point. Like, Later on in the game, you basically fight Marowak's ghost, and you can't catch it, so you basically have to make it faint. So, anything could be possible, I don't know. Someone make that a fan hack. Out of that, or don't. You have to roam far to get new kinds of Pokemon. Look for other types of Pokemon outside of Viridian Forest. Well, I want to believe that, but Viridian Forest has, like, a lot of awesome Pokemon in tow, so... Well, except for Weedle. Because apparently Weedle is banned in Viridian Forest in Pokemon Yellow. Like, I'm not even joking about that. Like, you can only catch... Out of the two, like, bug Pokemon you can catch in Viridian Forest, you can only catch, Caterpie and not, Weedle for whatever reason. I believe here, just like the anime, you can find Wild Pidgeotto here. So, yeah. Just shows how much I know about Gen 1 because I played it so many times. Like, Generation 2 might be my favorite, but Gen 1 is what I played the most. If it's not Pokemon Crystal, then it's definitely, like, Pokemon Red, Blue, and Yellow that I played the most, definitely. Alright, so continuing on our catching spree, we get Caterpie.
Caterpie, yeah.
Have you got Ninja Sex Party's new album? They released today and it's so good. I actually don't collect Ninja Sex Party, like, albums, but I do listen to their songs on YouTube and they're really good. They're really awesome jams. Like, my favorite being, obviously, Dinosaur Laser Fight, but... Yeah. But, I'm gonna name this guy, Feels? And that's it. Anyone who remembers that anime episode will certainly know. Never forgetty. And this guy, and this girl, is very poorly layered. Hi, do you have a Pikachu? Oh god. First legitimate trainer battle. That's only in Yellow. Holy shit. Okay. So, Nidoran female. Here we go. I forgot to put Feels out in the slot. Out in the first slot. Boo. Then again, at this point, it should only... Oh. That was a very good idea. That was a very good idea. Oh my god. Yep, Feels fainted. I got it today. I got it on iTunes and it's a cover album like 80 songs. Alright. Alright, pretty interested in that. Oh god, I need to blow my nose, but the toilet paper is like way over there. Ah, Jesus Christ. Okay. You know what? I'm just gonna live with it. Just work with the runny nose. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. It's just fine. But finally I learned Scratch. Jeez. Something other than, like, freaking... Tackle or whatever the heck. Okay. So just gonna continuously peck this thing to peck and back. Keep on using that peck. There. Level 8. Levels that, you know, Caterpie could have used, but nope. Oh no, really? Yeah, really. You're very poorly layered. Honest to God, you are. Oh god, I should probably, like, reload Twitter. Like, Jesus. I have, like, 102, like, unread tweets on that page I kept open. Now, you know what? I should probably just get through Viridian Forest first. Before I, like, catch any more Pokemon. Because I'm going to be here, like, forever just trying to catch all these Caterpies and junk. And you're just going to speed along through. Getting back to the center. To the center. And then going all the way back. because that's the main thing you'll want to do when you're playing on an emulated version of this game and all other Pokemon games. You should carry extras. Good advice there, buddy. Good advice. Maybe. Possibly. Hey, yeah, Pokemon, come on, let's battle him. Good. Maybe I can do that. Alright, now I'm gonna actually just grind up my Caterpie like nothing else here. I'm actually not planning on swapping out my Pokemon until, you know, after Pewter City, I believe, because, well, Pewter City is a thing. Pewter City is going to be a thing for, like, all of my Pokemon, honestly, there. And I have a feeling, like, my Pokemon are going to be, like, surprisingly under-leveled as heck because I got so many of them. But, you know, that's the price to pay. Well, that's the price to pay for, like, swapping out so many Pokemon. In fact, at this point in Origins, Red already had, like, 6 freaking Pokemon at his disposal. Like, I remember them clearly. Like, he had Charmander, Nidoran, Mail, Rattata, other such stuff. So, other than Pokemon, what else have you been playing? Well, quite obviously enough, for my YouTube channel, I do Let's Plays, and I've been currently playing, Ocarina of Time, Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time for my channel. And other than that, in my free time, I've been playing Xenoblade Chronicles 3D. And that game is amazing, by the way. You can't jam out if you're a Pokemon trainer! Yeah, I've been playing Xenoblade Chronicles 3D. It's my favorite game of all time on a handheld. And in total, it's my 4th playthrough of the entire game, and I'm OP as heck in that game. Just doing all the quests and junk. Sorry about that, had a little coughing fit right there, but I should probably, like, stop soon. Because I'm not doing the best job in the world. But yeah, Xenoblade Chronicles 3D. Excellent game. Excellent port. Good show. Good show. But other than that, I really need to get on my PS3 collection because I have so many unplayed games on there. Like, not only do I have a bunch of RPGs to finish on the on my PS3, but I also have Metal Gear to play. Just all sorts of stuff to play, honestly. It's just, the backlog is just so huge. That's the point of my backlog, it's just to be huge. Wouldn't say Ocarina is my absolute fave, but Wind Waker and Link Between Worlds are definitely my faves. Ooh, okay. So you didn't grow up on Ocarina at time. That's okay. That's alright, but Wind Waker is really good. Link Between Worlds I haven't finished. But if I were to pick my favorite Zelda game, it would have to be definitely Majora's Mask. Because that's also my favorite video game of all time. My second pick for favorite game of all time. Just because, well, I have a lot of memories with Majora's Mask, and I'm really digging Majora's Mask 3D, which is really good. Sure, they change a lot of things around it, but aside from those, it's just basically the same game, just on the 3DS, and with updated graphics and all that. So, yeah. Majora's Mask, favorite game. And Xenoblade, favorite game.
Level 10.
Huh? I ran out of Pokemon. Yep. Ran out of Pokemon indeed. Anyway, items. Potion. Do it. I got it on the 3DS first playthrough, and I haven't played it since I reached the Water Temple. Good. Water Temple is hell. No one likes the Water Temple. Just mainly playing Undertale instead. Yes. Yes. Undertale, definitely playing that. Good. It's a good game. I've done all three runs, and it's just an amazing game. Definitely agree with everyone in saying that. It's great. It's amazing. Sure, it's not my... Jesus Christ. Not really sure if I put Undertale in, like, top 10, maybe, like, top 15 or 20. But for an Earthbound-inspired RPG, it's amazing. Like, honest to God, amazing. My cops are gonna so pick up on the microphone, it's not even funny. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, okay. More Caterpies. Just, oh God, potion? Okay, just keep on doing this. There we go. Level 7. And for those Caterpie enthusiasts, you know what that means. It evolves into Metapod. Metapod. Yeah. So now we actually have a Metapod that can actually attack for once. I'm gonna be the best, like no one ever was. You just can't beat me. Dude, I have like 6 Pokemon at my disposal. You're gonna get wrecked. You're going to get absolutely shrecked by me. Because I have a Metapod that can tackle. By the way, not talking here because I fear for my throat. Like, if you're just tuning in, I feel my throat already about to die. Because MAGFest convention... Because convention, like, sicknesses are a thing. I'm still technically not better in the nose area, but... I was feeling better enough to, you know, at least record something. But, still... But still, I feel like I'm good enough to at least go on, and wow. This Caterpie is just... Wow. Alright, go John Cena! Do it. Just do it. Just kill it. Just make this thing faint. Just make this thing faint. Just go. You can do it. Oh God, I feel like I need... Okay. So I'm deciding. After Viridian Forest, I'm taking a break. Well deserved break to just blow my nose. Just walk my dog, who is sitting right next to me. Hello, Tootsie. And, yeah. Just, doing it. I'm making this a long live stream here, people. If I get disconnected, I'm sorry. Sorry, not sorry. Alright, you're just gonna harden all your Oh! String shot. Interesting. God dang it. To heck. My throat is dying right now. But I'm still sounding okay-ish. And you know what? Just speed through this battle. Just die. Thank you. I don't want to be here much longer. After all I did. That's right. You suck. You suck, game. You suck. Okay. Pidgeys. Level 8. Oh. Yeah. Okay, just die. There. Okay. Caterpie. Yeah, you know, I'm just gonna run. Not really feeling in the mood to just, continue on with battles here because my throat is about to die. Alright, Pidgey. Level 6. He's about to get shrek by freaking Pikachu. Level 8! Oh god, I remember this next trainer being like really hard. Like, honest to god, like, it could be like a difficulty spike, honestly. Beat through that battle. And trainer. Hey, wait up, what's the hurry? Well, I'll tell you what the hurry is. The hurry is that you have one Pokemon and I believe it's Never mind. I honestly thought it would be harder, but this is Caterpie, level 10. No, I'm thinking this hacked version of Pokemon Red, like Pokemon Red Advanced, I believe it was called. Which he had like a freaking pincer, I believe. Jesus. Coughs everywhere. And no, I am about to switch out because I am not about to have Spearow die. No siree. Okay. Level 9! Hooray. I could have had 100 experience from that. I give! You're good at this! Goody! And God! And oh, there's Metapods. Which they only know Harden and nothing else. So you know what, I'm just gonna speed through this battle. Because all it's gonna do is just harden. Oh Jesus! Okay, there we go. Yep. There it goes. And honestly, I thought you would... Honestly, my memory must be playing tricks on me, but... I could have sworn you could have ran into... the freaking... Team Rocket. Here, but... Nope. Not in Viridian Forest, nope. Because that's technically where... You know... Technically, where Ash had his first battle with Team Rocket there, but... Okay. Hello, Jigglypuff. You're only in this game. And fun thing, Pikachu will actually fall asleep. Heh. Oh, shit. It'll just wake up. It's a nice little fun thing. But anyway, we're here in Pewter City. And I believe that'll be a good enough place to take a break from this because I already feel my nose about to, like, die from mucus and all that stuff. So, I am going to, turn on some break stuff here. Gonna add a little bit of a break scenery. Brick. And the sources, I'm going to add image. Gonna browse through my things. Yeah. Okay, there we go. And bada bing. That should do. And from that point onward, I'm going to mute my Visual Boy Advance. Just so that I can save. So, I'm gonna feel like I'm gonna take a bit of a break here because, it's been like 2 hours at this point now. And I'm gonna keep on going until at least Mount Moon, I believe. So, that's gonna be like another like 30 whatever minutes of this. So you got to go, So see you around. Thanks for liking my artwork. Okay, bye. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming and talking with me. It's really nice of you to come by and say hi. All right. So with that being said, gonna start taking a break. Gonna walk the dog. Just gonna continue to, you know, tweet out the stream because, well, that's what I do. And I'm going, in a moment here, I'm going to take this time to do, to get some music in here, if I can do it. Hello, okay, there we go. Break time. All right. And continuing on with the theme of break music, might as well give you the epic pleasure of listening to New LA's nighttime, amazing nighttime theme from Xenoblade Chronicles X. So, it's break time. See you guys in a few moments. Okay. Oh, geez. All right. So, we're back. Should be back. And once again, I'm the only one. One is the loneliest number that you ever do. Two can be as bad as one. When just like number one is not number one anymore. Yeah. Okay. So, anyway, now we're back here. So, recall, we left off at Pewter City, so that, well, we could take a break, walk the dog, get some tissues that, which actually, I have my roll of toilet paper ready to go with all sorts of, you know, tissue stuff. So I can be ready at a moment's notice if my nose starts to feel poopy and stupid. So I could just continue on with my whole grinding session. Now, I'm not really gonna do like an entire like team grinding session because, well, this, because I'm really only training up feels just so that, you know, he can become a Butterfree, and, you know, because Butterfree is cool, Butterfree is cool. That's really all I can say about it, just because Butterfree is cool. Yeah. Also, Paul could use, like, a little bit of leveling up, too, because, well, because this gym, because this first gym is a rock-type gym, he's gonna need a fighting-type move, and I believe the first, like, fighting-type move he gets is low kick, which will be really awesome for, you know, fighting types, because, you know, I believe in this game it's also determined, low kick's power is also determined by the weight of the opponent. So when it comes to that, Mankey should do just awesomely against this guy. But if you get Butterfree will work pretty excellently against, you know, Brock, I think. Now, I know Butterfree will do really great against the first gym leader because, well, actually the first trainer in the gym, because I think in Yellow, the trainer only uses ground types and not rock types. So that will work out tremendously for, you know, Metapod, per se. So, yeah. Anyway, continue to lower my accuracy if you will. I'm just gonna... Hey, buddy. Hey, you missed him. Jesus Christ. Okay. Just, yeah. Just continue with that. Just go on like nothing ever happened. Just go on with your life. I did not mean to enter Viridian Forest, but okay. I guess we'll do that. Okay. It's gonna be a while, actually. Holy crap. Like, how much experience do these guys need? Apparently not enough to satisfy the needs of the many. And doesn't really help that, you know, most of my team is dying. So, yeah. Small grinding sessions are a thing when it comes to this sort of stuff. So, yeah. You know what? Things are stronger in the Viridian Forest, so that is obviously a good spot to train, I guess. Because there are freaking level 8 Pidgeys, and, you know, those can easily be defeated by Pikachu. And that way, Metapod can grow to level 10 easily and evolve! Because, you know, bug types are the key element when it comes to, you know, early level evolutions. So because level 10 is a great thing for Metapod, it can evolve into Butterfree and learn Confusion, which will do pretty good against the types of Pokemon that we're going to be running into in the Pewter Gym. And also, I believe Paul is pretty close to level. Should be. Come on! Thank you. Thank you. And you're gonna faint. Or not! Okay. Cool. Also, Paul is almost dead. Pikachu is not really gonna be really useful on this gym at all, since, you know, Pikachu is electric type, so might as well do some small grinding with him. Also, all this Metapod is literally going to do is just harden, so really no need to worry about that. Level 9, it should learn Low Kick? Yes! Okay, that's all I needed in terms of, you know, just actual grinding stuff. Nothing really too interesting is going to happen with them. I'm really only planning on using Butterfree and Mankey for this gym. They're going to be particularly useful. So, how much money do I have? Only 1655, okay. Cool. Actually, you know what? Dang it, I forgot to tweet out the fact that we're gonna be streaming again. Great. I'm an expert when it comes to, like, tweeting things. We return to yellow. Hashtag Pokemon20, because that obviously helps out. You know, if I get the hashtags out, I'll get more views. Because, you know, that's great. Okay. So, I believe they sell potions here. Yeah, they do. So I'm only gonna get 2. Meanwhile, they have no repels here, so I'm going to, well, get an escape rope. Because you never know what's gonna happen. Anyway, gonna explore Pewter City around a bit before entering said gym and defeat Brock. So, really, this 50 for a child's ticket doesn't really cost that much at all. So I might as well explore the Pewter Museum. Aerodactyl fossil, primitive and rare Pokemon. Haha. Yes. And a Kabutops fossil. A rare and primitive Pokemon. Yeah, okay. Sure. And this one? Meteorite that fell from Mount Moon. Moonstone? I like how they put Moonstone in, like, capital letters. July 20th, 1969! The first lunar landing! I bought a color TV to watch it! More like you bought a color Game Boy. So, whatever. Space Shuttle Columbia. This was actually changed up in Fire Red and Leaf Green because, you know, Columbia, you know, let's just say, didn't survive. So, I want a Pikachu, it's so cute! I asked my daddy to catch me one! Well, too bad. I have the only Pikachu in the entire world. You gonna do something about that? You gonna do something about that? I don't think so. Since I'm pretty much making this a live stream playthrough anyway, might as well tell you about that branch. We're not going to do anything about that until a little bit later. So let's actually explore around a bit, because I've never really gotten the time to explore around Pewter City before. Bow, 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 bow. Get that reference? No? Okay. Our Pokemon's an outsider, so it's hard to handle. An outsider is a Pokemon that you get in a trade. It grows fast, but it may ignore an unskilled trainer in battle. If only we had some badges. Well, here's an idea. Go ahead and get yourself a Pokemon. That way you can challenge the gyms and get badges that way. There aren't any serious Pokemon trainers around here. They're all like bug catchers, but Pewter Gym's Brock is totally into it. Well, then that means he's a serious trainer, I guess. Pokemon become easier to catch when they are hurt or asleep. But it's not a sure thing. Actually, it is, because Gen 1's catching system is broken. So some moves must be taught by the trainer. Haha. Indeed. Indeed, okay. So, I believe that will do about everything that there is to do, I think. So, talk to this dude. You're a trainer, right? Brock's looking for new challengers. Follow me. So once again, we get dragged out to our very well, and this is the longest time you're gonna hear this sort of song in the game. We don't even get to hear the full version of this thing in Gen 1. We only get to hear it, like, later on in the series, actually. Got the right stuff? Go on and take Brock on. Alright. And he just sort of just phases through the thing like it ain't no thing. I understand, like, if you somehow hack the game and you can phase through the wall, you will be able to actually crash the game that way. But whatever. Leader Brock. The rock solid Pokemon trainer. Alright. Hopefully we can cheat and use the sprinkler system, am I right? No. Hiya, I can tell what it takes to become a Pokemon trainer. I'm no trainer, but I can tell you how to win. Let me take you to the top. You can be my sensei. Alright, let's get happening. It'll be tough for your Pikachu at this gym. Electric attacks are harmless to Brock's ground-type Pokemon. That is actually not true, about what he said. This gym uses rock-type Pokemon, not, well, ground-type. Well, technically, all of them are technically into ground-type, so... Yeah, they're all ground-type, so... Pikachu is utterly useless in this gym. So Pikachu is going to have to get the back seat. Sorry, Pikachu. I know I'm underleveled, but I don't care. I'm taking this guy on. Stop right there, kid. You're still light years from facing Brock. I mean, I understand that, but... Yeah. Junior Trainer. I'm gonna send out Diglett. And I'm gonna send out Miley Cyrus. Okay. So, here's what I plan to do. Try to debuff this guy's Pokemon as much as you can, because he is surprisingly very tough in Pokemon Yellow. Whereas, I believe... Actually, I think he had the same Pokemon as he in Red and Blue as he does here. So, yeah. So try to debuff Diglett as much as you can, because all Diglett is just basically going to do is just scratch all the time. And hopefully, it doesn't get a critical... Okay, good. Good. Come on. There we go. There we go. You're a survivor, Miley Cyrus. You got this. Grow to level 9. He's about to use Sandshrew! Aw, jeez. Sandshrew, I swear to God. Which, by the way, you're unable to get Sandshrew in this game. At least I don't- Wait, actually, yeah, you are able to get Sandshrew in this game. What the heck am I saying? So anyway, here's the power of Butterfree here. Since Butterfree is a flying type, no ground type attacks will be able to hit it. Well, not that it matters, because none of these Pokemon have, like, any sort of ground type moves whatsoever. But still, Butterfree is incredibly useful. Darn! Light years isn't time, it measures distance! Haha! You are the loser and I am the winner. You suck. You suck. But anyway, yeah, I'm going back to the Pokemon Center because, well, I need to heal up for Brock because Brock is gonna wreck my ass. He's gonna wreck my asshole. Okay. So, I am going to... Let's see. Who should I use for this? Because I know Mankey's gonna make... I know Paula's gonna make sweet work out of that because low kick. But you know what? Yeah. Let's do that. Let's do that. Paul is going to take on this team single-handedly. Because low kick is amazing. Let's go. I'm Brock. I'm Pewter's gym's leader. Pewter's gym leader. I believe in rock hard defense and determinate. Oh my god. I never thought determination would go so far back as Gen 1. Holy shit. That's why all my Pokemon are the rock type. Do you still want to challenge me? Fine then. Show me your best. And for once, we actually get serious freaking gym leader music. Sure, it's still upbeat and all that, and the gym leader music is still really cool, but still. Gotta miss this serious upbeat style to it. It's amazing. Anyway, Geodude is probably gonna be, like, pretty much useless because low kick is amazing. Like, seriously, look at that! Low kick is so amazing, like, it got a critical hit and all that stuff, and it still works. In fact, I believe... Oh. Okay, so low kick isn't one of those moves where it's like, it can get a critical hit always in Gen 1. But the real show is Onix. And you know what? I'm actually gonna bring out Spearow because, well, Spearow needs the experience. Because, well, Spearow technically isn't gonna be used in this gym at all. And I'm kinda worried that, Onix has Rock Throw... You know what? I'm gonna chance it. I'm gonna use Growl. Oh, it's got Bind. Oh. Jesus. Well, at least unlike with other games, you can actually switch out because of Bind and stuff. And, oh god, it's got Screech? Really? Huh. Onix has surprisingly really good movesets for this. And oh god, Bide. Oh no. If I don't take it out, you know what? I'm gonna Leer it to debuff its defense. Two times. And then by the third time, I should do it. And no, 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 no! Ah, okay. Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. I could technically just use Butterfree. You know what? Yeah. I'm using Butterfree. Butterfree's gonna be the sole champion. Confusion. Alright. Come on, do it. You got this, Butterfree, you got this. No! Damn it. And here I was thinking Butterfree would be the sole champion. Pikachu obviously doesn't have any attacking moves on it to make it work. So you know what? I am... going for John Cena. Do it! Horn attack. Screech, that's gonna, like, really hurt it a lot, but... doesn't matter because I... wait. Because I did it! I beat Onix with the freaking Nidoran. I honestly didn't think that would work, but... man, that's actually pretty good. Good show. Good show, John Cena. Good show. And you grow level 9, Spearow. And learn Leer. Could have used that, I guess. I took you for granted. You didn't use any sprinkler systems at all. As proof of your victory, here's the Boulder Badge! I received the Boulder Badge! All one word. All one frickin' word. That's the official Pokemon League bat. Okay, I'm not gonna do that a lot. Like, okay. Its bearer's Pokemon become more powerful, and the technique Flash can now be used anytime. Yay. Wait, take this with you. TM34. It's literally a floppy disk with a CD inside it that you either stick up the Pokemon's ass, or you just basically, I don't know. How the heck are TMs used anyway? Like, how are they used? No one knows how they're used. Like, Fire Red and Leaf Green kind of explain it a little bit. Like, you attach some sort of machine onto, you know, Pokemon, and somehow that makes him learn the move. But in all other cases, who knows? Maybe they're instructional DVDs on how to do Focus Blast, or maybe they're instructional DVD, or maybe they're like motivational DVDs on how to like do Determination, the move. I don't know. Determination, the move. Okay. Alright, so, now that we've gotten our first gym badge, we can actually deposit some Pokemon here. Because Lord knows I'm just gonna swap out Pokemon anyway, so there's no way in heck I'm gonna, you know what? Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm gonna swap out, 2 Pokemon. What should I go with? I mean, obviously, Spearow is going to be a really good flying type for the team. Butterfree, I'm obviously going to keep. Nidoran Male. So, obviously, the logical two choices, I guess, would be depositing Mankey and Nidoran Female into the box. So, that's going to leave the rest of them with just those. All right. Okay, so yeah, all of them are healed. All the Pokemans are healed. Okay, we're good to go. Alright, so before we head out to another route, gonna go ahead and get more potions because I'm probably gonna need them. And obviously, more Pokeballs. Yep, I'm going flat broke. I'm going flat broke here and I'm going to do it. I don't give a shit. Alright. Okay. So, now we're on this route, and whoa, okay, I honestly need to, like, get rid of the Tom. You know what? I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna do that real quick. Because, well, you can deposit items into the PC, and let's just say the inventory in this game isn't really the best in the world. So, I'm gonna deposit the town map. And I don't really need TM34, so I'm gonna just get rid of that as well. And let me actually check the Pokédex here. Okay, I got 10 Pokémon, I've seen 15 of them. So, I can clearly get Sandshrew, I think. Can't get Diglett until later. Obviously can't get Geodude and then Onix until a bit. And then there's Eevee, which we will get later. Okay, so, now we're going all the way back here. So, for this area, I'm just gonna give some of my weaker Pokemon some of the spotlight here. Just because, well, you looked at me, didn't you? Well, obviously I did. I mean, when you looked in Trainer's eyes, that clearly means we can enter a battle. So, I'm just gonna use this time to use up the Pokemon that I have and just train them up like crazy. Okay, come on. Yeah, see, that's the thing. Sand Attack, when the AI uses it, is kind of cheap. Because, well, if they successfully land a Sand Attack, it's kind of like, well, you have all your accuracy lowered. So, like, even if you somehow manage to, like, get Sand Attack only once, it kind of... The game's RNG kind of makes it like, oh my god, you have your accuracy lowered to, like, the lowest that it can possibly be. So that obviously means, like, you can't do it. You can't do jack. You can't do jack shit. So, you know, it's like... It's not fair. It's not good. You're mean! Yes, I am, because I defeated you in a Pokemon battle. Yeah. Hey, I met you in Viridian Forest! If that's true, then how the heck did you manage to get over here? Like, honest to God, how did you manage to get over here? Like, that's a question for, like, many a Pokemon trainer's things. Anyway, I feel like I can deal with this Caterpie. And, yep. Dealt with it. Done. I'm a lucky bastard. Now he's gonna send in Weedle. Oh boy. Here it comes. Here comes the inevitable poison. Yep. I'm predicting it. Oh no, okay. Alright, so... Yeah. I swear to God, like... Poison Sting, like, nearly has its poison effect working all the time, I swear to God. Like, there were like, literal countless times where I would just be hit by Poison Sting, and the effect would always be, like, it just works. The poison effect just sort of works, and I do not get that at all, and I did not know that. Like, it's kind of, like, unfair. It's unfair to me. It's unfair to you, and unfair to everyone else, and yeah, that's how it works. Anywho, I think, like, this is a bug catcher next, or a young, yeah, actually, this is a youngster next, so I feel like I'm good with John Cena. Hi, I like shorts, they're comfy and easy to wear. Most famous line ever in Pokemon, not the fact that the anime has some really awesome lines, but that line right there is probably, like, the greatest line ever. Well, aside from one line that we'll run into later. But... whatever. But regardless of that, it's all good. It's all good. Oh, Jesus Christ. Apparently, that's what Quick Attack can do. I always have a feeling like these more powerful moves that Pokemon get early on are, like, somehow, like, really powerful and also really cheap at the same time. Like, Quick Attack doing that much damage? Like, how? How is that able to, like, come to pass? Like, honestly, how is that able to become a thing? I don't know. But... okay, Ekans. You're not able to get this in yellow, I don't think so. So... just gonna... you know what? Nah, I'm just gonna keep on switching out. Butterfree will do excellently against this thing anyway. And by the way, Wrap and Bind were OP in Gen 1. Like, you'll get your usual message of, the attack continues! The attack continues! The attack continues! And you know, Rage goes on forever. So, yeah. I don't believe it! But what do you say afterwards? Are you storing Pokemon on your PC? Each box can hold 20 Pokemon. Really? I did not know that. Huh. Are you a trainer? Let's fight! Fight Pokemon, not fight, like, actual fist fighting, but... you know what? Actual fist fighting, yeah, that works too. Thankfully, Poison-type Pokemon aren't really able to get poisoned, so the poison shouldn't be a non-issue at this point. It's only gonna do, like, one damage anyway, so... yeah, I think I'm pretty much okay to just stick with John Cena here. Kakuna! Okay, just gonna keep on using Harden on me. Well, guess what? I skip you, because that's all you're gonna do. Trust me. If any of you know the pain of just using Harden over and over and over again, you would know that battles where someone can only use Harden takes forever. And ever. And ever. Thankfully, I have emulators, so yeah. Alright, let Pikachu do its thing. Thank you. Bada bing, level 11. It's trying to learn Quick Attack. Okay. Alright. Delete room. Okay. I am not using any of these. But just because it's Quick Attack, going for. No! 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 God! No, don't you dare! Do you not dare! Thank you! Oh my god! Okay, my internet? Okay, not my internet, but my computer. No, 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 not this bullshit. No. No, no, no. I have my troubleshooting prepared. No. No. Bad computer. Bad computer, you're copyrighted. I'm watching you. No. Come on. Come on. You got the. Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna deal with it. I'm just gonna deal with my laptop being cancer. So, bye. 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 Seriously, I'm not dealing with that bullshit. I'm not gonna deal with that bullshit. You know what? I should just get like a really, really long Ethernet cable and just, you know, just get the streams from there. Like, I should honestly do that. Fields hasn't got. Laptop, no. Thank you. You're not being internet cancer today. You're not wearing shorts! Yes, that is clearly true. I am not wearing shorts at all. You are correct. I am not wearing shorts. Because I don't feel like, oh, snibble, snibble, snibble. I ain't. Yeah. No, yeah. Level 14! That is stronger than. No. 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 You're dropping frames like crazy. This happened to me, like, a lot of times in my Pokemon Red live stream, too. Like, just me constantly dropping frames. Just. I really hate my computer. Okay. Enough about that. Lost, lost, lost! Yes, lost, lost, lost. I am gonna heal. I'm gonna heal. Because this is just torture. Okay, I have to like literally stand still as my computer is just like dropping frames all the time. Like, seriously? Seriously, that look you gave me, it's so intriguing! Okay. Like, okay. Like, sure. Rattata. I'm going with the feels. Here we go. Okay, you know what? Actually gonna... blow my nose. Knows. Nobody knows the trouble this stupid laptop has seen. Nobody knows but Jesus. Nobody knows that my laptop can't be frickin' recovered. if the Sonic fan base will just do whatever Sammy Classic Sonic fan will want and just make a 3D environment classic Sonic game, whatever the heck that is. Like, that is Sonic Generations. That is literally Sonic Generations, I swear to God. It is. Okay. String shots. FIFA 14, alright. FIFA 14. Yeah. For Windows 8. I'm just, like, confused right now. And speaking of confused, yes. No, computer, you are not allowed to do that. Because I am not. Wait, what is this? I think he's sending out Metapod. Yep, Metapod. So, that's level 11. Wow. Confusion shouldn't really take that long. With confusion, Butterfree shouldn't really take that long to just, you know, deal with. Because literally, Harden is all it can do, and, Confusion is a special move in this game, so, yeah. And also in all moves, in all other games. Done like dinner! Yep. Done in just like the dinner. Now, there's actually a few more Pokemon that we can catch here on this route. One of them I am very looking for. Certainly not Spearow, that's what it is. But, I believe you can get this Pokemon on this route. No! Not Spearow. Not Spearow. Not Roy. Not Roy, indeed. Because, you know, I'm trying to set out to get every Pokemon out there that I can possibly get. And no, it's not Mankey either. Alright. Come on. Nope. Is this it? Is that it? No! I know you can get it in Pokemon Red. I know you can get this in Pokemon Red and Blue. But I'm not really too sure if it's, if it's viewable in this one. In fact, you know what? In fact, you know what? I'm gonna look this up. Alright, I'm literally going to go to, Cerebi.net PokeEarth, and I'm going to see this. Gen 1 Anchor. Okay, so you can't catch this. So you can't catch the Pokemon I was looking for in Gen 1, not really, but you can catch it on this route. Something that is not found in Pokemon Yellow, that's only in Blue. And whatever I'm looking for, it should be here. New. It's only like 15% of the time. According to Cerebi. According to Cerebi, it says. No. Jesus Christ. This is what Pokemon training can do to you. You swore to get every Pokemon out there that you can possibly get. And then you have roadblocks like this. There we go. There it is. Sandshrew. Alright, so hopefully I don't kill this because I really want to catch this. Sandshrew is pretty good. Like, Sandshrew is good. Because, well, it's got the defense. It's got the physical attack. It's all sorts of good. Fun to use. Especially if you can get it to Sandslash, because Sandslash gets the speed. Because speed is good. And, oh god, I have my mouse on there! Nope. Not risking any chances by doing that all the time. Okay, it should be good to catch it. Alright, Pokeball, do it! Hey, haven't really failed to catch a Pokemon once. That's pretty good. Its body is dry. When it gets cold at night, its hide is said to be coated with a fine dew. What did AJ name? Like Sandshrew, but I can't do that. So obviously, I must name it after something else in mind. I'm going to name it. No, not Ball. Ball? Ball Zig? Okay. Ball Zigs. Ball Zigs with two Z's, because using Z's is much better and cooler than using S's, because that's... Eek, did you touch me? No. I did not touch you, fine lady. This is a rated E for everyone game. Like, honest to God, like, why the heck did you... Wow, Sandshrew looks terrible. Sandshrew has seen better days. But, this is a rated E game. Madam, I'm going to paralyze you for that little statement. Paralyzes Jigglypuff. By the way, Jigglypuff was the Pokemon I was trying to find on this route. Like, I know you can find it in Red and Blue here, but apparently it's not there in Yellow. Very weird. But, whatever. Just gonna Thundershock this thing to heck. Because that's what I do. And wow. You can't touch me! Jigglypuff- oh. Well, there goes Thunder- Wave. Okay. Sure. Honestly thought that disable would work like as it did in the other games where it disables the last move you use, but apparently not. I win, suckas. That's it? That is it. Yep. That is it indeed. Well, not for the stream. The stream's almost over, but it... But I feel like I... Nah. I'm gonna... Phew, I better take a rest. Groan. The tunnel from Cerulean takes a lot out of you. Aight. Mount Moon ahead. Cool. Okie dokie. So. Now that we're here at the Pokemon Center, still can't talk to Chansey. I might add. Like, did they make Chansey not available to talk to in the Pokemon Center? Like, I know certain Pokemon Centers allow you to do that. But, what the heck? Like, still. What do you have to say? I have 6 Pokeballs on my set in my belt. At most, you can carry 6 Pokemon. Cool. Team Rocket attacks Cerulean citizens. Team Rocket is always in the news. Pretty much just like Donald Trump, am I right? Hello there! Have I got a deal just for you? I'll let you have a swell Magikarp for just $500! What do you say? I say yes. I mean, I'm not gonna use Magikarp. In fact, I'm just gonna call it... Flop? God, Flop? Koi? Oh wait. No. I should be fair to this. I recently listened to the Japanese Poke Rap thing from the olden days, and I'm gonna name this thing Koi Kingu. Yep. There it is. Magikarp with its... Oh god, its eyes are dead! Its eyes are honestly dead! Look at those eyes! Look at it! What the heck is up with that? But yeah, there's no way in hell I'm using Magikarp. No way in hell, because, well, I think you can get its evolved form Gyarados at some point. in the game. But let's actually see. How many Pokemon do I have in my PC? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Still good. It's still good to go. Okay. So, just to give a little bit of a brief overview of what's happened here so far. I got Sandshrew, which is all awesome. I now have John Cena being level 11, with 11 experience to get. You know what? You know what? I'm going to keep going and just make it so that John Cena can be a level 12. That's what I'm going to do. That's obviously the thing I'm going to do. There. Easier than rare candies, because it can learn Double Kick. Man, Red and Origins must have been really lucky to get this. To get to level 12 so it can get Double Kick. Honest to God, yeah. That's what it can do. Can't escape. Why? Why not? Okay. Good. Okay. So, let's see. I don't really think I can do anything else for the time being. So I'm just gonna heal up my Pokemon. And then, I believe with that being said, gotten past Brock, started this live stream playthrough as it were, gotten through all this stuff with my stream being disconnected. I'm probably just gonna edit those streams together and then make it into a midnight upload or something on YouTube, because that's what I do. And stuff. And yeah, that'll pretty much do it. I'm not really entirely too sure when the next stream will be. Like, maybe like next week if I can get around to that. I'm probably just gonna make this like a weekly thing that I do, and for Pokemon Yellow at least. For, you know, the 20th anniversary and stuff. Because I love Pokemon Yellow. Like, Pokemon Red and Blue were like my first games. And might as well share my love in a live stream playthrough. So, yeah. Anyway, I think that'll about do it for this. Sorry to all those people who literally just came in. And literally sorry to all those who just left, because I know they're gonna leave as soon as I mention them, because that's what happened like a bunch of times. But yeah, I think that will just simply wrap up this little time of ours, in which, you know, we got started on our adventures in Kanto once again. We got, you know, the Boulder Badge, and yeah. So I might as well save Mount Moon for next time, because Mount Moon is going to be hell. With all those random encounters, no repels. This isn't Fire Red and Leaf Green, where we can just simply get repels at the Pewter City Pokemarts. No, we got to deal with those random encounters, because this is back in the day. This was back in the day when repels weren't even a thing until Cerulean City. That will be certainly a challenge indeed. So hopefully I'll actually find another way to just, you know, make the stream more stable. Anyway, that will about do it. See you guys later, and thanks for stopping by.